Hi, I'm Scott Flowers with Cloud Ninjas. Today we're here to continue our series on the HPE ProLiant DL380 Gen 11 server. In this video, we're going to specifically focus on VMware ESXi. Let's get going. Well, hey, thanks for stopping by today to learn a little bit more about the HPE ProLiant DL380 Gen 11 server. Do us a favor, if you find anything that helps you in this video, click that like and smash that subscribe. All right, let's hop in. Now, this video is going to be specifically dedicated to VMware ESXi. So what we're going to do in this video is start by going over the compatible versions. Then we're going to show you how to download an ISO file, which we will put in our description section of this video. Then we're going to show you how to create a bootable USB, because you're going to want to take that ISO file and put it onto your bootable USB. And then we're going to show you step-by-step instructions on exactly how to install ESXi onto your Gen 11 server. So let's go ahead and hop into the compatible versions. Well, there are two compatible versions. You have VMware 7.0 and 8.0, and it does take all three versions of 7.0, and it does take both current versions of 8.0, and I'm sure there will be more versions out in the future, so do us a favor. This server will be around for many years to come, so as new compatible versions drop out, just drop a comment down below to let people know, just to keep everything up to date for all the different users. So, all right, well, let's hop in and show you how to download the ISO file to start. All right, so now what we're going to do is show you how to install VMware ESXi. The version that we're going to be updating to in this video is 8.0.2. For this installation, you will require one bootable USB with the VMware ISO file mounted onto the USB. You can create a bootable USB with a program called Rufus. You're going to need at least 8 gigs of RAM, and you're going to need configured hard drive or solid state drive to a RAID. The system needs to also be in UEFI mode.
Hey guys, today I'm going to show you guys how to install VMware. But first thing we're going to do is we're going to create a bootable USB drive. In order to do this, you need to go ahead and download the VMware ISO file from the description. If you want to go directly to the VMware ESXi website, you can go ahead and do that as well. And you'll have a little bit more options on what you want to download. But I will note that you may have to create an account before you can do this. So you can go ahead and just go to that link in the description. It'll automatically download that ISO file, and then it'll save you a trip from going to the VMware website. But once you go ahead and download that VMware ISO file, you want to go ahead and download a program called Rufus.
All right, so now we need to create a bootable USB. We are going to use a program called Rufus. So we just go into Google or to a web browser in general and search Rufus, download the program, and run it once it is downloaded. Plug the USB into the computer that you downloaded Rufus on, and under the device in Rufus, make sure the USB drive is selected. If you only have one USB drive plugged into your machine, it will be selected by default. Leave everything under the default settings, then click the select button and choose the ISO file that we downloaded in the previous steps. Click start to begin creating the installation USB drive. During boot, we're going to press F11 to go to the boot menu. Please wait for the server to finish the initialization process, and this could take a couple of seconds to a couple of minutes. On the one-time boot menu, please select your bootable USB and press enter to start the installation process. In this case, our bootable USB is rear USB 2 USB disk 3.0. Let the installer run until you see the Welcome to VMware ESXi 8.02 installation message and press enter. Then on the end user agreement, press F11 to accept and continue. Let the program scan for devices and then select the drive where you want to install VMware and press enter. So now it's going to make you choose the default keyboard layout. In our case, we are going to use US and press enter. Then you're going to want to confirm your root password and press enter. Now the installation process will begin, and it may take a little bit of time. After the installation process finishes, please remove the bootable USB and press enter to restart. After this, the server will restart as normal and it will boot into VMware. Congratulations, you've successfully installed VMware ESXi. Hey, if you made it this far, click that like and smash that subscribe. And if you're looking for any custom built HPE, Dell, Supermicro, IBM, we do new and we do use, and we'd love the opportunity to earn your data center's business. Please email us at sales@cloudninja.com. That's sales@cloudninja.com. Thanks for stopping by, guys. Take care.